President-elect Donald Trump's charitable foundation has been under scrutiny and is the subject of an investigation by the New York Attorney General. The Washington Post is now reporting a new revelation that the Trump Foundation admitted to the IRS that it engaged in self-dealing and legally misusing charitable donations to benefit himself, or actually itself, for business or his family. Joining us now is the Washington Post reporter who broke that story, David Fahrenthold. David, happy Thanksgiving to you and the family. Good to have you with us.
Thank you.
Let's do this through the lens of the opposition it will receive, okay? People, the first blush will be, well, what's new? Didn't we already hear this and it wasn't any big deal? What do you know?
Well, what's new is the Trump Foundation, Donald Trump, is now admitting to something that for a long time they told the IRS they had never done, which is, as you said, take money that was in the charity that was meant for charitable purposes, serving the public good, and spending it to benefit Trump or to benefit one of his family members or one of his businesses.
And so, what was the penalty, and how can we substantiate as reporters that this matters?
Well, the penalty we don't know yet. There's a separate IRS form that we haven't gotten a copy of yet, in which Trump will lay out all the specific instances that he broke this law, and he will describe the penalty taxes or reimbursements he will have paid. I don't know that yet. I've asked for it, but haven't gotten it. And you asked why it matters. I mean, this is a guy who's about to be responsible for faithfully executing all the laws of the country. It's important to know he's been running a federally certified charity for a long time. Has he been following the rather simple laws of how to run a charity?
Trump Foundation may have been receiving donations from foreigners during the campaign. How do we know, and how much are we talking about?
Well, the one example we know about is in this same tax filing. In September of 2015, when Trump was already obviously a pretty major candidate for president, he took $150,000 from a guy who is a Ukrainian steel magnate. And the $150,000 was in exchange for a 20-minute speech Trump gave by video link. He sat in Trump Tower, talked over the video for 20 minutes, and got $150,000 for his charity. Now, the same Ukrainian steel magnate was a guy who donated heavily to the Clinton Foundation, and there were questions raised about whether Hillary Clinton, as Secretary of State, showed him sort of extra favoritism. It's just one donation, but you see the potential here, right? This is a president-elect, will be a president. If he keeps the Trump Foundation open, this is a way for foreign governments, foreign businessmen to give money to a cause close to Donald Trump. And because of the way the IRS rules work, we wouldn't know about it for a year or more after the gift came in.
You have been tuned into the potential hypocrisy of what Trump was saying about Clinton, despite what may be going on with his own foundation. That seemed to have also taken you down the road of what the Trump Foundation was doing during the campaign. In addition to this type of foreign donation, what did you find?
Well, the biggest thing that the Trump Foundation did during the campaign was, you recall back in January, Trump had this big fundraiser for veterans in Iowa, and he said he raised $6 million. A lot of that money went into the Trump Foundation, and then Donald Trump gave it out to people. So this is money from other people. Trump would go on the road at his campaign rallies and stop the rally and then bring up a local veterans group from Iowa or New Hampshire and give them a giant, oversized, Ed McMahon-style check that said Donald J. Trump Foundation on the top, and Make America Great Again on the bottom. Now, it's illegal to mix a nonprofit's work with that of a presidential campaign. Trump obviously used the Donald Trump Foundation, again, other people's money, to boost his image in Iowa, New Hampshire, and other places. That's another example of something we might see the IRS or the New York AG take a look into later on.
The idea of where that money went, I don't know what you found. Our Drew Griffin was looking. We were never able to account for all $6 million that he said he raised and sent off to veterans groups. Do you think that's just about accounting and time, or do you think it's about something else?
Well, what I found back then was that Trump took all the money in and said he raised $6 million, including $1 million of his own, and he gave out a little bit right at the beginning, a little bit more than $1 million at these sort of high-profile gifts in the middle of his rallies, and then he stopped. And then for months and months and months, I and Drew and other folks were trying to figure out what happened to the money. Did Trump give his $1 million? Did he give away the rest of the money that other people had entrusted to him to give to veterans groups? And it took months of media badgering for Trump to admit to a couple of things. One, he was was sitting on his $1 million. He hadn't actually given it out, even after his campaign said he had. And he didn't give away a lot of the money that other people had entrusted to him until much later. You remember he had a very angry press conference at Trump Tower in which he said, "I can't believe you're making me account for this money that I took from other people, account for where it went." So that was not a very encouraging sort of example about the way that Trump views the public trust of being donated money to help others.
And the foundation is another example of the advantage to Trump of a private concern, right? Is that until it does its tax filing, there's really no way, unless you get good tips and really work it as a reporter, to know what's going on inside of the operations, right?
That's right. The Trump Foundation is more transparent than Trump himself because it has to release its tax returns, unlike him. But the way the IRS does this, all the information about 2016 won't have to be revealed until November of 2017. And same thing for the next year. So if Trump got $1 million in his foundation from some foreign government on the day he was inaugurated in January 2017, we wouldn't know about it until the end of November 2018. So it makes it a very difficult, as you said, a very difficult way to understand, very difficult place to watch. It's a back door that foreign governments or businessmen could use to influence Trump or suck up to Trump in a way that would be really hard to watch until much later.
So hook me up, Fahrenthold. We're always on here pumping your reporting. What are you looking at next? Give me a little bit of an advance of questions you're asking.
Well, a couple of things. One is, how much did Trump actually pay in penalty taxes? What were the specific acts of self-dealing that he admitted to? You remember during the campaign, we found some pretty big ones. He said he bought two giant portraits of himself with money from the charity, including one he hung up in his sports bar. He spent $258,000 from the charity to settle his business's legal debts. All those things appear to be violations of self-dealing law. Which ones does he admit to? And speaking of the foreign donations, I've asked again and again, how many foreign donations has he gotten since 2015? How many did he get from foreign governments during 2016? And will he do anything to try to limit the conflicts of interest this will pose as president? Hillary Clinton, as you recall, signed an MOU with the Obama administration when she became Secretary of State, set to limit foreign donations. Will he do anything like that?
Mm. David Fahrenthold, again, good Thanksgiving to you and the family. Thanks for being on New Day, as always.
Allison? You too.
The president.